It's Christmas, and I'm giving honesty and truth and gift, you know, as a gift this year. So there's another asshole I need to say Merry Christmas to. So I'm looking, and Chestnut Checkers, I'm up for their content, I do. I think they do an awesome job. So I'm looking, and they got something about Master P and Brian McKnight exposing their ungrateful children. Now I can understand why Master P is trying to do, like, some damage control because he robbed his son. I said as much myself. I believe Romeo completely. Because when that nigga was back with my girlfriend, Kima Dyson, from Total back in the day, he was cheap as fuck, and he was worth hundreds of millions of dollars then. Master P cheap as fuck, so I know he robbed his son. Like, if a woman will leave Master P to marry a man that owns a car dealership, you gotta ask why she dropped that on that millionaire. And she had a great life with Carlos. But it wasn't enough to stay with Master. He ain't have enough going on. So I know he cheap as fuck. So I understand the damage control. Especially considering how his daughter Odina, now the whole family, saying that he left her out there to die. So I get that. But Brian McKnight had something to say? See, that really puts a bee up my bonnet. And there's a reason why it puts a bee up my bonnet. His ex-wife is my cousin, Julie McKnight Johnson. Now Julie Johnson. She's the mother of his older children, his first children. He was a piece of shit father, and he was an even worse husband. And see, I know things about Brian that most people don't know. And it was hard for me because he was married to my cousin, and I tried to mind my business. But there was, you know, there was a pro in Philly that I went to school with. I've spoken about her before. Her name is Paris. Well, she danced by Paris. She was dancing at Delilah's, down Spring Garden and Delaware Avenue, the same time that Amber Rose was when she met Kanye West. So Brian was one of my girlfriend from high school's clients. But see, the thing that most people don't know is that nigga got a real sick fetish because he used to pay her extra so that he could choke her out and punch in her fucking eye. And he would just sit there and fuck her and beat her and fuck her and beat her. And sometimes I would go and I would pick her up after calls. And I'll never forget the one time I came to pick her up after she had been with Brian.